Hey, welcome to Profitology with your friend, trusted advisor, CFO, Perry Jeffries. Hey, thank you for joining us for another episode here at Profitology, where we discuss creating profits not only in your business and your personal finances, but also into your life, your health, and your wealth. So if you've been following us, we've been doing a series called the COVID-19 Survival Kit Series. And today, it's going to be one of those transparent conversations. We're talking about asking for help and where to go. So again, asking for help and where to go. So let's start off this way. This morning, I experienced a large amount of overwhelm. I had a lot to do, 20 some odd tasks, frustrated, fatigued, overwhelmed, and we have a weekly team meeting, team huddle, every day at 9:30 a.m. So my team is four of us now. We're on our huddle, and I just came flat out and said, I need help, literally. So there was no hesitation. There was no, wow, I'm the CEO of the company, president of the company. Are they going to look down on me because I asked for help? No, absolutely not. With zero hesitation, I need help. And just like that, my team jumped in. What do you need help with? Okay, let's list out everything you need assistance with. Okay. And they start dividing up the tasks. Okay, I'll handle this. I can do this. I'll jump on this. And I say this to say, anytime I've experienced any amount of success in any aspect of my life is when I opened up my mouth and said, I need help. I didn't BS around. I need help. Which lead me to a couple other stories I'm going to share here with you. So nonetheless, my team got me out of my head. They jumped in. They took some of the burden off of me. I still had some tasks I need to do, but I went from maybe having 20 tasks then down to having five, and the team jumped in and started helping everything else out. So let me ask you this, group. How often do you ask for help? A lot of times we don't ask for help. We see this a lot of times, even with more so even with men, that we don't ask for help. And there's nothing wrong with asking for help. Asking for help is not a sign of weakness. Asking for help is actually a sign of strength. The humility to come forward and say, you know what, I can't do this by myself. Or, you know what, I'm not the expert in this. I need help. So I'm going to tell you guys another story. So we dealt with this morning. And boom, just like that, I've knocked out of the five or six tasks that I have to do today. I've knocked out, I think, three or four of them. And I'll have these knocked out here before, probably before 1 o'clock today, because my team helped me out and they've been phenomenal. So even with people that you are, in business with, or family, or whoever the case may be, do not hesitate in asking for help, and do it just like that. I need help. Okay. Another scenario here. This happened, geez, y'all, this is probably now 2015, I believe it was 2015, 2016, maybe. I was struggling in my business. I have ventured off on the entrepreneurial route 100%, not halfway in the job, have like all in as an entrepreneur. And that's what I was going to do. And I looked up and I was struggling. I was super busy. I was overwhelmed. I was tired, and I was making 30% less that year than I had made the previous year. And so something I did is I reached out, picked up the phone and called an expert. And I knew he was an expert because I had been in a mastermind group with him that he facilitated. I saw his results of how he helped other individuals create 6, 7, and 8 figure businesses. And he had been a huge help to me. So I reached out to him and I said, hey, man, I need help. I don't need kumbaya. I don't need theory. I said, I am overwhelmed. I'm working 2 times harder than I've worked ever in my life, and I'm making 30% less money. So if anybody has experienced that, raise your hand. And when I reached out and I asked for help, and he gave me just that. And that's when I was able to create a consistent six-figure income with my business, because I asked for that help and I invested in his expertise. So then it goes to the reason I share that story is recently, as of yesterday, I have a good friend of mine who's an accountant out in the DC area, and he reached out to me and he said, Perry, you got to share this with the audience. They need to ask for help, but they need to go ask for help from experts in those particular fields. So let's go back to what I was initially sharing with you guys at the beginning of the story, how I reached out to my team and asked for help. Well, everybody on my team has a different specialization as far as a skill set. We have, you know, personal team who's super solid in operations and creating systems and things of that nature. We have another person who's phenomenal with graphics and marketing. We have another person who's just phenomenal with just knocking out tasks super quick. You know what I'm saying? Whatever you give them, they can just knock out super fast, regardless of what it is. So I didn't go ask the marketing person to do my operations. I let the operations person handle that. I didn't go ask my operations person to do the marketing. I didn't ask my person who annihilates tasks like this, that like, hey, can you go in and create systems? No. So when I asked for help, the way our team was built strategically, everybody has their area of expertise. So they all dove in their element. And that's how they were to help out and take the burden off of me as the CEO. So let that sink in, y'all. And this is what my friend was sharing with me from DC, the accountant. There are so many people needing help in this time during this crisis. But are you going to the people who can actually help you, or the people who are just giving you advice, or they just read an article on Google and they're telling you like, hey, you should do this? This is the time to identify the experts who can help you. If you're having issues with your mental health, identify the expert, the therapist who can help you. If you're having issues with your business, this is time to identify the business expert. If you're having an issue with your finances, this is time to identify the finance expert. If you're having issues with your, you know, spirituality, this is when you identify your spiritual expert. This is the time to not play around, but to ask for help, but to strategically ask for help from individuals who are expert in their particular fields. So that's what I want to share with you guys this morning. Nothing technical, I want to share my experience where I felt overwhelmed. And, you know, folks be like, oh my God, Perry, I feel overwhelmed all the time. Thank goodness for having a phenomenal support system with respects to my family. Thank goodness for being having structured the right team. And I reach out for help and ask advice all the time, y'all. So again, asking for help is not a sign of weakness. It's a sign of strength. It's a sign that you've acknowledged, hey, I am not good in this area, or I may be okay in this area, but if I want to take this particular area of my life to a next level, then I know I have to go and ask for expertise, right? So that's what we have today, y'all. Let's see if we had any comments here on the thread before we get off. But if I want to take this particular... Good. I've been asking for more help. Perfect. All right, y'all. So, hey, that's conclude our segment of, the COVID-19 Survival Kit series. Ask for help, but ask for help from the right people, right? Because right now, everybody has an opinion. Everybody's reading all the articles. And during this time of crisis, and using this time of crisis kind of just as a benchmark moving forward, don't ever hesitate to ask for help. Asking for help can save you time, energy, and money, and especially if you're getting help from experts. So again, Perry Jeffries here with this episode of Profitology. As always, if you want to connect with us, go to perryjeffries.com. If you go to perryjeffries.com/free resources, we have access to some videos there to help you for in areas of our expertise is dealing with, you know, finance and investing in entrepreneurship. Take advantage of those free resources and always feel free to reach out to us if you need some help. You have our hotline number, 614-763-6553. And again, Perry Jeffries, your profitologist. Peace.